Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Alhamdulillah. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of this divine grace, mercy and permission, biiznillah, we continue our da'wah to train a life coach through Khalifah Education Foundation and Post-Islamic Psychology Center. And we have all our YouTube channel. And we have a new channel which I'm developing some more. Yeah, that is the Islamic Integrative YouTube channel, which we'll announce later on. All right. So what's important is that with this knowledge of Islamic motivation, coaching, mentoring, Islamic heart of love, and Islamic integrative healing, we can then become a healer to ourselves, our family, the ummah, and humanity, bringing them to the deen, the beautiful way of life that they heal internally. And that is something that is very important, because right now we have this allopathic medicine, all right? And I'm going to explain to you in detail why it is just only atheistic, materialistic medicine, but an integrative medicine will contain all the realms of existence that I have explained to you in the previous video. So this is for us to have a holistic life in the 21st century, including permaculture living, an integrated self, family, ummah, and an integrated global world where we can live in peace and harmony, not in war, not in destruction, not in greed, not in injustice, not in inequality, and so on. So we have to bring about this new idealism. It's all in the book. For example, we have this Khalifah Circle approach of how to bring about a change. So you can study that. All right. So what is important, I have given to you many ideas in terms of the Fita and Tifa cycle, of the integrated self at the feelings, emotion and thoughts from the higher realm, and the Tifa cycle based on the lower realm. So we have within us the four realms of existence, our Ruh, Qalb, Akal and Jasad, body. And this is the Post-Islamic Psychology model, the first model in the world. It's also in the book. You can study deeply and how you can use this for your own self-development in terms of motivation, coaching, mentoring, Islam heart of love, also in promoting healing. How to use this, including ru'yah and so on, all can be applied, inshallah. So what is important is that from this understanding of the higher thoughts and higher feelings, integrated with the lower thoughts, we bring our nafs towards a higher level, in which from nafsul ammara or nafsul shahwaniyah, haywaniyah, we go up towards iman ainul yakin, nafsul lawama ainul yakin, nafsul mutmainnah, and hakul yakin, nafsul radiyah, mardiyah, and kamaliyah, which I've explained to you. And how, with the advance of modern quantum science, the integrative ability will then be better. In terms of healing, we are not talking about healing in the gross or material self, but integrating with the subtle world and the quantum world. Because the cells, actually, as you divide the cells into elements, into atoms, subatomic particles, as it goes further and further, it just become no more particle, it is just wave. So you have this quantum waveform, and how it is integrated with the spiritual world, which need a lot of research by Muslims. So what is important is that we know the hierarchy of being, or the hierarchy of reality, from the Islamic metaphysical point of view, from Nasut, Malakut, Jabarut, Hahut, Lahut and Hahut, the realm of the material, the subtle, the angelic, the divine qualities and the divine essence, and how as an integrative person we use our Ruh, our Qalb, our Akal and our body to integrate, so that we live within the integrated self of not only the physical body, the terrestrial or the intermediate world of the quantum world, and then the intermediate world, subtle world, the celestial world, and the infinite world of the realms of the Zat of Allah, which is beyond us. But we are learning, for example, we study Al-Mutawheed, we study the Sifa of Allah, the attributes of Allah, all the possible, all the wajibul Sifa, the Sifa that is wajib on Allah. Allah has infinite number of attributes we do not know. It's mentioned 99 in the Al-Quran. Within Al-Mukallam, 20 is selected. Some say 13, the other one is another 7. It's a manifestation. So all these things are all integrated, so that we know that if we live within the integrated self of the Ruh, the Qalb, the Akal and the body, we can overcome all diseases. So human being now today is facing a lot of diseases that is manifested in the mind. So what are the anything that's manifested in the heart and in the mind and in the roh will be manifested in the body. That's why when you talk about these psychological challenges, we have this PICBT, positive Islamic psychology model. And if we look at all kind of challenges that modern human being faces, I just list up a few: simple phobia, social phobia, cognitive delay in childhood development. All these, there are answers for the integrated Islamic healing. Teenage problem, panic disorder and agoraphobia, obsessive compulsive disorder, depression, generalized anxiety disorder, post-traumatic stress disorder, schizophrenia, schizophrenia, bipolar mood disorder, alcohol drug addiction, psychosexual problems, relationship problems, bulimia, anorexia, insomnia, chronic pain management, and so on. So we just can list, and the list go on and on and on. You go to the DSM-5, you have the whole stack of the maladies of modern man. All right? But you go to another file, they have all the diseases. For example, you go to allergic medicine. Just on the heart alone, they have 20 different diseases of the heart. Heart valve damage to heart blockage to thickening of the arteries and whatever, you name it. So they have just on the heart, maybe on the ears, another 100 types of diseases. Maybe on the stomach, the guts, many, many types. So all of these things combined together give us a very depressing view of life if we do not know how to integrate that our physical body that is manifested is just a reflection of our way of life. That means a reflection of an imbalanced, greedy, materialistic, sex-based, consumption-based life will lead to all the maladies, whether it is so psychological or physical. So we are combining all these things, inshallah, including ru'ya, because in Islam we have ru'ya, but there's also a misunderstanding of ru'ya is always about jinn possession and so on, whereas ru'ya is a very simple mode of you. You have your ruh, your qalb, your akal. This is you. You have an integrative self that can link back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is you that has to do the work. So Allah tells us in the Quran, what it is in Surah Baqarah, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. I have sent down this Quran, wa nunazzilu minal Qur'ani ma huwa, in it shifa, healing. So you have to be healing. Shifa wa rahmatun, and a rahmah. Rahmah is what? The wave of the rahmah, the energy, the basirah, the ilham, the all the spiritual shower from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma huwa shifa wa rahmatun lil mu'minin. So all the believers. So that is the basic idea of an integrative self and integrative Islamic medicine or Islamic integrative healing, which I'm going to give you a new YouTube channel, so that with that we can correct the perception of humanity from the perspective of just treating our body, but to use our strength in terms of our roh, the power of our roh, the power of our heart, the power of akal, to change the body. And that can be done. That's why they say, oh, it's a miracle. No, it's not a miracle. If you have cancer, if you believe in healing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your cancer can be gone. Oh, but they say, how can you do it? It has been proven over and over a lot of, for example, great Sheikh Shuyuk, Awliyaullah, they have all these abilities, not because of their abilities, but it is from the shower of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we as Muslims, as Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we believe in miracle, but you got to see your own miracle, that it can be done with your integrative self, using your roh, your qalb, your akal, and your body to fulfill the need to be near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah tells us in the other verse of the Quran, which I read before, that Allah tells us, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ they ask you about the roh, say the roh, the knowledge is with Allah. But Allah also tells us about I'm close to you. So Allah tells us that He is near and He answers your prayer all the time. So if we have disease, we have psychological challenges, we have fear, we have worry, we have depression, we have cancer, we have heart diseases, you name it. When you turn to Allah and you synergize your four rims of existence, remember our spiritual, our roh, our qalb and akal, based on our model. I've given you the model. Okay, this is our model. Inshallah, this is an extrapolation of Imam Ghazali's model, that our nafs, ourselves, is a reflection of our existence, of our roh, existence of our kalb, existence of our mind, and this jasad can then be directed to be integrated into our way of life, a holistic, loving, caring, sharing, wonderful, happy life that Allah blessed us with. So we have a choice, a life of miserableness, a life of psychological challenges, a life of diseases from all the disease of the world, or a life, we have challenges, but we understand the nature of our temporality within this world, that we live only for 70 or 80 or maybe 100 years max, and then we return to Allah. But we have a life after this physical world because our roh, our qalb, our akal is not destructible. These are forms of subtle creation by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to exist beyond space, beyond time, to exist in the akhirah, to exist in Jannah, to have the fullness of the radiance and the grace of Allah, inshallah.